second session will be handled by Dr. K.T. Shashikumar sir with his motivational speech and discussion. I request Pradeep Mandal sir to accompany Dr. K.T. Shashikumar sir.
But what you can ask me should be told, and I don't want questions to be asked, and I'm sure most of the people have hesitation in asking. So last month there was one call up on me on Indian Express saying I'm a WhatsApp guru. I met few people who met me here. Where they had few questions, we had discussions. So you can take my number and you can WhatsApp my questions to me. I take it up. 944. You can store my number 944-74. If as Vipin says, you have to be faster. Let me see who is going to ask first question. I will give you some gift for the best question and the first question. 944-74-37-948. That's my number. But to open the discussion, probably no two keys are required to open a lock. So two key speakers are not required, only one is good enough. So he already opened it. I can only enter now inside. And my brother Gokulanji was kind enough to give nice introduction, on which whatever I prepared is finished. So I don't have anything else to add on Vivekananda. But I only have to say the Krishnarpanam, the name itself. The just one song we had was Vande, and the title of today's program also has Vande. Vande Vivekananda. And most of the people think Vivekananda is important. But for me, Vivekananda as a person may not be important. What his message is more important. That's why we don't have Vande Vivekananda, we have Vande Vivekanandam. So what is that he says to us is more important than the individual. Always Bharatiya Shastra was like that. Dharma is more important than Dharmaputra, than Dharmaraja. It is immaterial who speaks. What I speak is more important. What you take out from today is more important than who gave it to you. Vande, my namaskaram. to Vivekanandam, the message what Vivekananda gave. Vivekananda was very clear in his messages. A known follower of Bharatiya Shastram, a strong man with a lot of muscles, probably a man, a saint who must have done everyday gym practice, who must have crossed Bhagirathi river, because his house was very close to Bhagiratha river. Bhagirathi river itself is great because it is one of the tributary, the distributaries of the great male river, the only one male river which we have, Brahmaputra, which is, once it starts flowing, it's a havoc. It's like that. Vivekananda is also like that. And he was, muscles was very good. That's why 3 days of Kanyakumari, nobody could follow him, and he was undisturbed for 3 days of meditation because other Swamijis were old enough, they could not swim across. That time there was no bridge, no ship, no small boats also. So he just swam across. So he was a great swimmer. Physically he was great. Intellectually so sharp. A book is not to be read completely. You only look at the last page and say, I know what is inside. As if references are good enough to understand a paper, if you are a real researcher. If you are a good reader, you don't require to read the whole thing. The first paragraph and the last paragraph will tell you what is the content. He was such an intellectual man. Emotionally, totally controlled, because there was a great joke on Vivekananda. When he went for one speech, it was less than 4 minutes. And he had a lot of stage fear. The morning schedule was rescheduled 3 times and then he gave the last chance. But next day newspaper carried only his name. He was such a great speaker. He went for only one day, one speech, but he stayed 1 year because the demand of the public was so much. He continued his speeches at different places. And he got lot of, he was a very handsome man. Extraordinarily handsome, fabulous English. The vocabulary was, you had to refer dictionaries to understand what he speaks. And then he used to get a lot of lectures. And he was staying with somebody, they said, we will also read those letters to answer. Vivekananda said, no, you cannot answer love letters to me, because most of them were love letters. He was a young bachelor and he got a lot of love letters. And one young lady came to him and asked, I love to marry you because I want to produce a child as good as you. Then he said, marriage is guaranteed, but no guarantee that you will get a child like me. But I can guarantee one thing. Ma, you are my mother from now onwards. Take me as your son. So that guaranteed son. What an emotional control. What a great speech. What a great method of attracting people. It was fabulous. I think Vivekanandam, when we read, it is not seeing his poster, understanding what is behind him. There are hundreds of stories which I can tell, but we don't have time. Probably in my life, if I can write one book on Vivekananda's unsaid messages. I have a great friend of mine who edited my poetry book. Her PhD thesis was on Vivekananda's poetical aspects in quotations. Each quotation has poetry inside. And I was blessed to have such a person as close friend of mine who edited my book. And she used to tell me how people get attracted to Vivekananda just because of the words, the way the flow happens in his speeches. And that's why he was there, stayed for 1 year, where he went for only few minutes of talk. I'm sure when you understand Vivekananda, that's what we should understand. Second one, the whole 10th year anniversary we are celebrating as Krishnarpanam. Krishna has only few things to ask his devotees. One is karma, because basically he is the Vishnu. Vishnu is representing karma. So always people say you have to be active. There was one great question that why poverty in India? Only one answer, people are lazy. I'm sure there is no poverty in India if people are ready to work. But if you always demand for a greater job, I'm sure that cannot be guaranteed. I have been interviewing people, civil engineering people for a civil engineering company who pays fantastic. We got 50 engineers from 3 different IITs. 150 people were appearing for interview. At the end of interviewing 150 engineers, civil engineers, the report was given to the owner of the company that none of them are qualified for job. They are IITians. When IIT people come for interview and I was an executive director of an engineering college, I asked basic question, what is gravity? To a mechanical engineering person, he is not able to define it properly. Okay, I'm not here to find fault with education system. Education system is good, India is great. But unfortunately, people are bad. We all take things for granted. We always want to say the system is bad, system is bad, system is bad. No, system is fantastic. And if you are good, you can go beyond systems. If you are good, if a teacher is good, he can go beyond classrooms and teach. But that's where we are lacking. We always find excuses for not doing things. If we can change individually, today there was a great talk on change. I was so impressed. I made beautiful notes. I have not seen the other participants taking notes from the other speakers. I think they are all much brilliant than me. But I was keep on writing notes, especially few, I am not mentioning those names because the prize may not go to them. There are few great speakers who made beautiful points. But unfortunately, all of us, I was just Googling to find out the people who changed the world. If you Google, you will find 10 people. All those names were mentioned in the speeches. So that means our speeches are always Googled and then brought in. We don't read. We don't read for understanding. That is why you are not mentioning, nobody made mention of Vivekananda who made changes in the world. Why? Okay, you are not making change for the nation. Vivekananda 100% made change in the nation. Because lot of leaders were followers of Vivekananda. Netaji was follower of Vivekananda. If Netaji made a difference, if Mahatma Gandhi made a difference, it's just because Vivekananda. So if Vivekananda could be a leader who made changes in this nation, and he predicted India is going to have freedom before Congress could think about freedom. So he was such a visionary. And I don't know why the speakers did not mention Swami Vivekananda in speeches. Okay, forget about Swami Vivekananda. I keep always confused and ask question whether Swami Vivekananda is great or Ramakrishna is great. I never got an answer. Whether teacher is great or the student is great. Because we know Ramakrishna just because Vivekananda existed. Otherwise Ramakrishna would not have been famous. Ramakrishna mission, Ramakrishna activity were famous just because Vivekananda. If somebody gets a good student, I am sure the first aim should be to make the teacher famous, or his mission is to take his guru's mission forward. I am sure Vivekananda did it. Therefore, if there is a change in Vivekananda, I am sure it is just because of Ramakrishna. So a person can change one person, I am sure you can change a nation. Okay, forget about it. There were great people who conquered the whole world and they could not enter India just because of a great personality called Kaudilya. Nobody mentioned. He was only a small teacher. But that small teacher could gather most of the rulers of that time to fight against. I'm not mentioning. You Google and find out. You're all good Googlers. If I am sure you can, you will not find this in the Google, people who made changes. But you are staying in a land, but only one person's name you will find, that is Mahatma Gandhi. But now let me ask you, who made Mahatma Gandhi the real Mahatma Gandhi? You will not find many places because there are contradictions. You understand, when Mahatma Gandhi wanted to jump into politics, he went and met Gopalakrishna Gokhale. Gokhale said, you cannot jump into politics like this. Go and see India first and then come back. Let me give an interview and then find out if you are eligible or not. And he did it. So it is Gokhale who made Mahatma Gandhi the real Mahatma Gandhi. So behind somebody, there is a teacher, a mentor, a guru. Understand, that's a tradition of India. And that tradition is what is our culture. And that is what we should spread. When we say Vivekanandam, we have to spread that message. I am important because my guru is important. And that happens only when you have the dedication to change this world, to understand the culture of this country. I am sure you need a thorough reading, a great knowledge, I'm just looking at questions, only 2-3 questions came. So let me have 10 more questions. So until then, I will start pouring something here and there. Let me pour some sambar or chutney, and maybe the real essence will come later, what is to be used for eating. The environment concept in India, today's discussions. I don't know how many of you are aware of Kaavu, the sacred place beside a temple. That's a part of Indian environment system. Deshakupam Ekavapi, Deshavapi Ekadati, Deshanadi Eka, etc. etc. It says the sun is unimportant, the putra is not important, more important is vriksha. Understand this concept. I have not seen anybody quoting this. That is why you have to learn things so that things will come to you. But somebody was getting close to temple, I thought he is going to mention few more things around it. No, it did not happen. Our concept of the youth, confused or confident, I'm sure most of the people are confident. Confident in one thing. The whole program was discussed, the Yuva program. I suggested we should have a lot of competitions. The first reservation was the youth is between which age to which age. Then we decided maybe some 15 to 18, 19. Immediately all the people who gathered said, no, we will not get anybody from Hyderabad. We will not get anybody from this group of age people because they all had great virus. You know what is that virus? Today we hear about a great virus in this world. Which is that? Coronavirus from China. Hyderabad had this virus nearly 30 years back. It is a China virus, and that is Corona. Not Corona, Corona, the Hindi Corona. And it is a China Corona. What is China? Chaitanya and Narayana combined together. There is only one option after 10th, you have to do either Chaitanya or Narayana. With this China Corona, people will not go for anything else. If at all you are good up to 10th class, 11th and 12th is the real filtering and washing and dry washing and cleaning. And you know, recently the ex-China Corona group of people who are all ex-students of Chaitanya and Narayana filed a case against the same institution saying that we are all kept inside room, that whenever you get virus you have to be kept isolated, right? So they were all isolated, never allowed to go home, only study from morning till evening, and prove that you become totally useless but with good marks, wonderful marks, and they will all reach, you know, where? Some BTEC. And India produces 5 lakhs BTECs, out of which 0.1% goes into the core engineering subject. 4% gets jobs. The rest of them get job not because they are BTEC, they are good otherwise, right? And immediately after going, one of the best institution which appoints this BTEC is Infosys. You know what do they do? They send them to Mysore. And in Mysore, you know what do they teach? 10th class maths, 10th class English. Because they forgot the 10th class. Therefore, they need to write examination. 6 months they have to write examination. Keep on writing examination, prove that they learned this basic thing. Then they will be put into job. And many people fail there also. And it is continued for 1 year. Wonderful. That is our Indian engineering. You know, the number of engineering entry in the whole world, India stands first. But the engineers in the world, India is not in the first or second. We are in the 14th. That is because entry is good, but they feel they are all useless. The same 10th class syllabus, 11th and 12th class syllabus. I taught math, physics, chemistry in the engineering also. Then I found the same chemistry, maths, physics, but the pass percentage is 4% to 7%. The best to them. The best of the best engineering colleges produces this. That's because of the so-called the virus which we spoke just now. What is lacking in this country is not education. It is not education system because we are really good. But what is lacking is the people. That is why Vivekananda said the tushni bhavam. We are all like pretending that we are sleeping.
Therefore, we don't even sleep. When we wake up, we don't have that energy. You should have good energy when you wake up. That will happen only when you sleep peacefully. What is lost is the peaceful sleep. It is important to have physically strong, emotionally strong, intellectually sharp, socially active. I've got plenty of experience talking to people. I find the children have no questions. Understand? Why they don't have questions? Because every child by birth have questions. They will keep asking, what is this, what is this, what is this? Up to 1 year, 2 year, 1.5 year, that's it. After that, the mother will say, don't ask questions. As teachers, they keep on saying, don't ask questions. We will ask questions, we will also give you answer. That's it. Question and answer is given by. Just now I met one of my closest friend who had sent me some polytechnic teacher. He's there. Yeah, come here, beta, come here. You are my student. I get some students like this. And he was telling, unfortunately, I'm a teacher. I said, don't use that word. He's standing there. Come here. Don't worry, you can ask questions. I said, don't say that's a blessed thing. I left my job to become a teacher in my life. Otherwise, I would have been in Prime Minister's office. I left it. Because the best thing what you can do in your life is to teach. You came to me because I'm a teacher. And now you say that I don't want to be a teacher. Civil engineering is such a wonderful topic in this world, and he feel it is not worth teaching. It's because the students are not absorbing into the merit. This is the product in this world, you know. I can make somebody to pass from one class to another class without seeing them fit. A teacher is a doctor. You also conduct a test examination. Doctors also conduct a test and examination. But the problem is, the doctors will not release the patient unless they are 100% fit. The teachers will promote them without being fit. So the virus is being carried from grade 1 to grade up to your. That's your problem, not your problem. But you can find out and rectify. So now you will become a teacher? Definitely. Wonderful. Give him a big clap. That's it. Salute. You want to ask anything to me? Did you send a WhatsApp? Yeah, he's a good boy. You send a message. Okay. Most of the teachers don't have questions, but I have some teachers who have got questions. See, understand, this is important to know what my student really require. If I don't know what my student require, what do you teach? I generally say, there is one great college in Kannur from where I hail. The result was fantastic. Students got good marks when the college was almost closed the whole year because of strike. That means the teachers don't teach, they perform well sometimes. And if they teach, they don't perform well. That's what it shows. That's because, you know, the generation, the biggest problem is, earlier when I used to go back to my home, somebody comes to my house and says, sir, we were classmates. When my brother, who is 4 years elder to me, he comes also, the same person will say, we were classmates. I asked, how come? Yeah, I failed in grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4. Today nobody fails, you will just pass. And such people who passed without merit are the teachers today. That's the biggest misfortune we have. I conducted an examination, not examination, an elocution competition like which we had, in which one topic was given, education. They were all given to one district, Kerala, for all the principals. They wrote title. They have to give a title and then give it to me. That's it. Immediately I shuffled it and said, you pick it up and then start speaking. They said, no, not for us. Only we can give it to students. We cannot do this job. Fine. I picked up the papers and the knocked and seen, out of 23, 16 education spelling was wrong. They were principals of the schools. No exaggeration, I'll tell you. Still I keep those papers. I'm very good in documentation. This is the status of our education. This is where it is lacking. If you don't get any other job, become teacher. That has been our schedule. Don't. Once upon a time, the best were teachers. Because it had a merit in the society. That is lost. It is our responsibility to get it back. I'm sure we have to celebrate Teacher's Day when president resigns and becomes a teacher. Not a teacher becomes a president. That's the biggest crime India did. Right? So we have to rewrite things in this world. I'm sure then we can make a lot of changes. I don't want to mention anything more because I crossed my given time. Now I will pick up some questions. தசகூபம் மேகவாபி, somebody has typed it. இது போல மகாபாரதத்திலே வரிகளான இது, I am not very sure. Most of the Sanskrit slokas, Mahabharatam itself is not one version. I am coming in Shrestha Bharatam as a judge from tomorrow for 1 week. In during the time also we had lot of conflict, which Mahabharatam? Because Mahabharatam itself is, many people have written Mahabharatam. So when we follow something, the other contradicts. See, you know, Ramayana itself is more than 60. So if I say Sita is the daughter of Ravana, you will kill me. But there is Mahabharatam in which says Sita is the daughter of Ravana also. So we will have problem. So don't ask from where is it from. It's all from one book. Which is that book? The Bharatiya book. That's it. Okay. Putran Marka Tulyam Uri Maram Ennan. That's correct. Yes, wonderful. That's an information to me. I am thankful for that. Why the idea of Vivekananda is not taught in the school level? You know, there are Vivekananda is a person who is being claimed by many people now. Probably it will come back again. The different people have got seen the color. In a different lookup table, if you print, that looks reddish. So some states who are ruled by, you know, only one state, they are going to introduce Vivekananda as their party leader. So it may come back. Because what is included in education system depends on which party rules. And Vivekananda was not a member of any of the parties. That would have been one of the reasons. I mean, why do you want, I don't know, nobody learns the dancer who spoke on the stage. I'm sure she did not learn dance from the schools. She must have went outside and then learned. We have a great place in Hyderabad, very close to this place, Vivekananda Institute for Human Excellence. Fortunately, I was there for 12 years as a teacher in the morning and evening. I used to have a lot of youth as teachers. 100 rupees, you will get 150 rupees book and for 5 days of classes, 1 hour, 1 hour. Beautiful system of learning. If you want to learn Vivekananda, you should learn at that level, because learning Vivekananda is not simply possible with the present teachers. It cannot be taught in the classrooms. Because I'm sure if you learn My Eternal India, one book is there by Vivekananda. I must have read it more than 25 to 30 times. Then I kept it aside because I will have to go back after some more knowledge. Then only we can understand few pages. The few pages in the beginning itself talk about education. It is very difficult to understand. It's not that simple book. India, Eternal India, Vivekananda's book. If you get time, go through that. Then you will understand why Vivekananda cannot be taught in classrooms. Otherwise, Vivekananda will be taught as a person with his life history, but not Vivekanandam. If you want to learn that, you have to be a Vivekanandam expert before teaching. That is very difficult, okay? That may be one of the reasons it is not being taught. There are plenty of questions, yeah? Good, wonderful. I'm so happy. What is lagging in the youth in India in competing with the independent learning of other country youth? You understand, I was in US 6 months and I was taking tuition for, generally I don't entertain tuitions, but I took tuition for SAT SAT examination, which will make children to qualify to go for graduation. I found that a 8th grade Indian student will be 100% better than a 12th grade American student. We are much, much better. Don't say that, no, we have less knowledge. We are very good in maths. We are very good in reasoning. We are very good in logical analysis. Including English, we are very good. Because they don't learn grammar in the style in which we learn. I don't know, the present generation may not learn. In my generation, we were forced to learn 12 tenses. I take, I am taking, I have taken, I have been taking, I took, I was taken, I have taken, I have been taking, I shall take, I shall be taking, I shall have taken, I shall have been taking. Like this, we have to by heart, learn by heart. Learn by heart. But today's generation, heart is not there, they have given to somebody else. That's a problem. If you stop that, half of your problems will be over. You will be very good. Logically good, mathematically good, English is good, science is good. They have experts, but we are pert. That's the problem. We have not become ex. We keep on changing our subjects and learning. They create people for a specific job. Therefore, they have experts. They create one person for one job. We don't do that. We want versatile genius. I am a versatile genius and I am unfit to be in America because I don't know anything. I know many things. That's a problem. Okay, that's like in the PhD in mathematics, knowing more and more about less and less. That is knowing more and more about less and less. That's Western system. But here, knowing many things about nothing is our objective. So that's where we change. Okay. The big question, I think it's 3-4 pages which I cannot read now. I will just skip. We should know how to ask questions, yeah? As you said, the laziness is the only reason for the poverty. Agreed. Your words, and even I am lazy So how should I kill that laziness? Drink 3 liters of water before going to bed tonight. Morning you will wake up early fast. The laziness starts with waking up. No, waking up, everybody wakes up because Brahma calls us in the morning. Brahma is the husband of education system, you know, right? Brahma is the husband of Saraswati, the education minister. Definitely, if you are a student, she will send Brahma, ask Shashi, get up, Shashi, get up. I say, poda, you go. Because I am sleeping that time only. I am sure during the daytime, even if I call their cousins like Vishnu or Shiva, they will not listen. Their wives also will not listen. Therefore, you cannot earn. If you want to learn, L-E-A-R-N, learn, you will have a L board. Remove L board, you will start earning. Right? That is our Bharatiya education system. Karagre Vasate Lakshmi. Chant once. Karagre Vasate Lakshmi. Don't do like this. Do like this. That means you understand the meaning. So most of the time we don't understand meaning. To show that you know, understand meaning. Karagre Vasate Lakshmi. Chant. Karamadhye Saraswati. That means if you have Saraswati with you, education with you, money will come to you. You don't have to hunt for that. If you are highly educated, people come behind you and they will pay you as much as you want. I have students after BTech got job in 27 international, multinational companies in Hyderabad itself. So it's very simple. But there may be another BTech who is hunting for job. No, don't become a iron powder, be a magnet. Then you should get attracted and people will come to you. That's what the quality you need. And I'm sure if you have got Saraswati and her husband Brahma, Brahma is the god of creativity, you will start asking questions. If you have got education, no questions, you are foolish. You have only Saraswati, not her husband. Definitely husband will call her away and you will be abandoned without education. So I'm sure if you have L-E-A-R-N, learn, then L can be removed once you are expert in driving. L board is not required, then it becomes earning. And if you have good learning and good earning, I'm sure you can peacefully sleep. And that is what is Shiva does, the god of meditation. I'm a Himalayan master from meditation. Our god is only Shiva, where peacefully sleep. That is possible only when you have his wife around you, that is Shakti. So Karagre Vasate Lakshmi, Karamadhye Saraswati, Karamule Sthida Gauri. You should have energy. You should have, this is the best motivation. No Dr. TPS can give you best motivation lecture. This loka you chant every day morning, look at your own hand and say, Lakshmi is in my hand, Saraswati is in my hand, and Gauri is in my hand. All the three goddesses are given in your hand, only from one nation. And that is Bharatam. Himalayam samarabhya yavat hindu sarovaram tam deva nirmidam desham hindustanam prajakshade. No other place in the world goddesses are given in your hand. Take it. And then start practicing it. I'm sure you will become the best person. Your laziness will go. So drink water and then don't spoil your bed. Okay? So that is what is to be done. So I'm sure you will become good. Whom you inspired? My good question. Whether I inspired somebody or the grammar is bad, whom I got inspired with? There is a great person who inspired me totally. Each point of time, LKG teacher was my best teacher during that time. I got inspired by him. During my academic education time, I had a great science teacher who inspired me in science. We keep on changing. You don't have to be all the time in LKG. As you go PG, I understood my KG teacher is not that good. But I had a PG teacher who was brilliant. So we keep following different people. When I learn yoga asana, then maybe I will have a yoga teacher. But when I learn meditation, that yoga teacher never know meditation. So probably I'll change my guru. So I had the blessings of greatest meditation master, Mahamandaleshwar Swami Vedabharati, who is Rama's disciple. So I'm blessed to be the meditation student of the greatest meditation master of India. And I'm also a student of the Vedic Pandit from Kerala, Brahmasri KPC Anujan Bhattadaripad. So different places I keep on changing my place. If that is the question, and if the question is today, who is my greatest inspiration? There is one person called Dr. T.P. Shashikumar. I keep my own picture bigger and then say, oh, please inspire me, please inspire me. We create our own greatest picture. That's what is to be done. Definitely Vivekananda was my inspiration because his presence of mind is beautiful and fantastic. I don't have time to explain the stories of Vivekananda. When some time permits, I'm sure if you are interested, I can elaborate on that, right? Nice to meet you, sir. I am Ramesh, working in Leicester in civil engineering. I have two questions. One, how can we inculcate in youth to look every lady as his sister. No, don't look everybody as lady, as sister and mother. You'll have problem. The population will not be there in this world. Now it's gone single. There are a lot of problems. Not because, see, we know our mythology doesn't talk about everybody to be your sister and mother and all that. We need to consider most of the people who are elders to us as equivalent to mother, youngers as equivalent to our sisters and younger sisters and daughter. But you should also have the concept of swadharmam, family dharmam, and samuha dharmam, and rashtra dharma. Understand this dharma perfectly. We have great knowledge around the purusharthas, kama, artha, moksha, but only in the dharmic style. That's why I put dharma at the end. So first we should have desire. The desire is good. No desire is bad in this world. But unaccounted, uncontrolled desire is going to be disastrous. So what is to be done? The kama can be satisfied only based on the dharma. The dharma is important. The dharma also keeps changing. Maybe in the early age of our marriage, we have a family dharma. And from there, you have to jump on to a societal dharma. Understand you have great things to do for the society. Then you change your dharma. That's why we have got different levels of life. We have a kudumba dharma. And then we have a sannyasa dharma also. In divorcing your wife, you can be inside your family, but your thoughts can be in that. And people say that vanaprastham. Vanaprastham, what is the translation? Many people keep saying that going to forest. It's wrong. It is not vanaprastham. It is vanaprastham. It is space department. Okay. Vanam is space. That means without any disturbance, you must be able to move yourself. Don't ask permission from somebody else. Maybe in childhood and grihasthasramam, you will have to ask permission from many people. But you will get a plane like a space. You can move anywhere you want. And you will not make scar. Even the rocket goes, immediately the scar is removed. Therefore, you don't make scar with anybody else. You don't create scar in yourself also. That free nature is what is called vanaprastham. Reach into that level. So it's a great science to be taught. I'm sure the time permits, we will have some sessions only on the purushartham and the life which we will have to live with all the dharma around us. How can we measure the learning capacity of a student? Count the number of questions which they ask, and the questions are meritorious, then the student is wonderful. It is easy to give answers, but very difficult to prepare questions. I generally say a person have to get 100 out of 100, he must be able to predict 100 questions. And those questions are coming in examination, then he will get 100 marks, correct? If my predictions are not correct, I can only predict 90% and I will get 90% in my examination. That's very simple. So predicting question than asking question is more important than answering. So make your children to ask questions. Then I am sure you are a good teacher. So that is what is to be done. There the creativity will be understood. You know that the student is able to ask questions. Generally in my lectures, that's what I do. I am so happy there are plenty of questions keep coming. It is important to join schools or colleges like China. It is important to join schools and colleges like China. I don't know whether China has got a different system. China has a different system, as I know. They have got a good education system, not because the students like to join or not. Every teacher has to write examination before every year, academic year. That means they cannot have the old knowledge to start teaching today. Every teachers are supposed to update with their knowledge. If they don't qualify that year, they are not teachers in that year. That's it. It is not a permanent job. Here the teaching is, once you become a teacher in a KG system, 100% sure. You know one simple question when I go to schools for teachers training program, I ask. The KG teachers also can improve. Generally, people feel they cannot improve. I ask a question, who wrote a Tingle Tingle Little Star? I could never get an answer from any of the KG teachers. And I ask them, go and Google at least. That you can also sing a Tingle Tingle Little Star. Teacher also can sing the same thing. You are not different from a student. That has to be understood. So teachers are good in China, but here teachers get a permanent job. That's the biggest problem. And the system in China is entirely different. We have Make in India program. China controlled their population because of the government policy. If I am employing somebody else as my employee, if he produces two children, I will have to throw him out of my company. Otherwise, I will be punished. Therefore, no people can produce two children and have a job. So if somebody has by mistake two children, what is that they should do? They should start a company. That is how China started different companies. Got it? That is one of the mechanism. It is not entrepreneurship. It is the livelihood problem which made China entrepreneurs. And therefore what happened? Chinese people are rich, but Chinese government is not good. China is not developing. It is progressing. There are a lot of difference. Like China doesn't have citizens. They have individuals. You understood the difference? An individual becomes a citizen when a country becomes a nation. You should have the feeling. Nation is a feeling. Western system doesn't have a nationalism. They have one country. The American president will speak, oh, countrymen only. We don't speak a countrymen because we don't have country people here. We have only people who have got a feeling for nation. And that feeling is what we should have. And that will come only when the earlier the song was saying, you have that only when you have Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. You should salute this nation. And that is why we say Matru Bhumi. The Bhumi is our Matru. It is our Amma. And by mistake, we have to stamp on that. We have to spit on that. We have to throw every dirt on that. Nothing wrong. And that is why we have a system first to say, sorry to Mother before you wake up and then put your legs on. Read my book, Nitya Sloka. In the net, you will find out what to be done every day to follow the Indian system of prayers. I crossed 3 minutes, 5 seconds extra. Sorry for that. 35 minutes was given to me. Few more questions are there. I will send individual answers to them. Okay. So I must thank all the people who are not on stage. I am sure for the last few months, Hari never had sleep. Where is Hari? Huh? Where is he, Hari? Hari, dress ka change the dasala to. He's a great man. He's a great. I think I'm sure when I suggested, he had a lot of reservation on program in different routes. Last 3 Sundays, 4 Sundays or 5 Sundays we had. There are a lot of judges who supported. Most of the time you see Menon everywhere. And no sir, no clap for Menon. Give big clap for Usha, who permitted Menon to go around like this. Right? You need a good support from family, then only it happens. I'm sure Madhavan, who is the person, come here. You know the relationship we built? My son is now a nuclear scientist just because of Balagogulam. My son is doing his project in America as a nuclear scientist after completing his PhD in UK just because of this man. And the contact is Balagogulam. I'll tell you, the personal relationship which we bind ourselves has got lot of advantage. It is not academics. There is something called beyond academics. We remember 2010, 2009 we started Balagogulam here. 2010 we were there in Thrissur. And that small contact over a casual discussion with Unnikrishnan sir is what made me the judge for Shrestha Bharatam. So I'll tell you, there are a lot of relationship which we can build. I'm seeing after 10 years, 15 years, Sukumaran all the time. Advocate Sukumaran, please stand up now. He's a great man. A man of lot of capacity to bring things together. We see a lot of people. I got introduced to many more. I don't want to name. Kamala Nagar is because of him. I said, no, he is not Raksha Adhikari. Raksha Adhikari is God. And he is the man who holds God within himself. It's one dedication. I'm sure I'm seeing a lot of people. I don't have to name everybody. My friendship with Pradeep, I'm sure he was a small boy when he came. Now we became almost great together. Right? Vipin was a small boy on a small cycle the time when we came. Now he is running shows. A silent man who knows how to organize things. These bachas are all small, my kids, where I started teaching. I was sending the first photograph we had on the Balagogulam. What a great change. I'm sure this is what makes people great. The social life. If you are not a social being, you are not a human being, you are not socially active and being human, it is not to be called as human being and social being. Manushya rupena mrugacharat. Like a human being with the two-legged animal is moving. That's it. That's what the life is. Don't become a two-legged animal in your life. Life is to L-I-F-E, live in full enjoyment. Learn in full enjoyment. Learning is an investment for future earning. Entertain yourself and follow your passion. I'm sure the youth have got lot of capacity. We were really wonderful to see the students talking blah 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 blah, but I'm sure little direction, little facts and figures, little hesitation is ruled out from them. Language is fantastic, ideas are good, but need to read little more and then grow. I'm sure you can change this world. I'm hopeful the world is going to have the greatest leadership from India, and not one Vivekananda. The Vivekanandam is getting to each one of your heart. You can be Vivekananda and change this world. Vande Mataram. Namaskaram to each one. If I left somebody's name, it is not intentional. Just not coming, who are not seen in front. There is a boy there, he is always with. He need to improve his education, that's it.
Thank you, sir.